Georgia on My Mind, Skylark. Couple of Hoagy Carmichael's great tunes played by the Gene Krupa Band. You should listen tomorrow morning, by the way, between 8 and noon. Ted Strasser is going to do a program on the great Hoagy Carmichael and trace his life and career. Be listening. We'll break right now for NBC News on the hour at 1 and return with the next hour of Night Flight. This is the great voice of the Great Lakes, WJR Detroit.
NBC News. I'm Carol Kuzewski. But for the palm trees, President Reagan's Western vacation resembles a White House powwow. It seems to be business first, as we learn from NBC's Dan Blackburn in Palm Springs.
Foreign policy has been the focus of much of President Reagan's attention during his week-long California stay, with developments in Poland heading the list. He conferred here Saturday with Secretary of State Haig and with close aide Michael Deaver and Deputy Secretary of State William Clark, the man expected to replace Richard Allen as White House National Security Advisor. Their talks covered several foreign policy bases, including Tuesday's scheduled meeting with West German Chancellor Helmut Schmidt. They also reviewed Allied reaction to the sanctions Mr. Reagan imposed last Tuesday against the Soviet Union. Dan Blackburn, NBC News, Palm Springs, California.
A report from West German radio indicates that Artur Rakowski, the son of Poland's deputy prime minister, wants to emigrate to Australia. Rakowski has been living with his family in Wiesbaden since June, the report says, and hasn't seen his father since leaving Poland. More news in a minute.
Hi, Mom. All set for the garage sale?
I'm not going, Judy.
But why, Mom?
I've got a nagging backache.
Oh.
You see, I started cleaning the house for the party next week, and
And you overexerted yourself, right?
Oh, I guess.
I'll get you some Doane's pills.
Doane's pills? Of course.
Good advice. For temporary relief, get Doane's pills and get the better of a simple muscular backache due to overexertion, stress, or strain. Doane's pills are available at drug counters or your favorite supermarket. Use only as directed.
What was that all about?
A smoke alarm. Your cigarette smoke set it off.
Some joke.
Yeah, well, those yellow stains on your teeth are no joke.
What do you mean?
Here, blow some cigarette smoke through this white handkerchief. See that stain?
Wow, no wonder my teeth look so dingy.
Yeah, you better get some Topol.
Topol, the smoker's tooth polish, used regularly. It helps remove all kinds of superficial yellow tobacco stains. Week after week, watch your teeth get brighter and brighter. Topol, the smoker's tooth polish, now in 3-ounce regular or 7-ounce fluoride. Use only as directed.
The Soviet cruise ship Odessa dropped off hundreds of Americans and other passengers at the port of New Orleans Saturday after sanctions by President Reagan banned it from again entering a United States port. Passengers said they'd been cut off from newspapers and radio during the week-long cruise through the Caribbean. They said they were kept in the dark about the restrictions imposed by President Reagan as a reaction to martial law in Poland. And this report from NBC's Ned Temko in Moscow says those restrictions are not fitting well with the Soviet Union.
A dispatch from New York in this morning's edition of the Soviet Communist Party newspaper Pravda says that Washington is in effect giving its European allies two choices. Either the West Europeans go along with U.S. sanctions against the Soviet Union, or the Americans will call off the recently started talks with the Soviets on nuclear missiles in Europe. This, Pravda says, amounts to blackmail and to American disregard for West European interests. Some West European diplomats here feel it is unlikely the Americans will cancel the arms talks and see the latest Pravda article as part of a Soviet bid to encourage strains within the Western alliance. Ned Temko for NBC News, Moscow.
Houston, Texas, the nation's fifth largest city, has its first woman mayor, sworn in Saturday, 35-year-old accountant Kathy Whitmire. This is NBC News.
I'm home.
Hi, honey. How was your physical exam?
Okay, but I really have to quit smoking.
Mm-hmm.
I've made the decision.
Can you?
Darn right. I bought these.
Bantron Smoking Deterrent Tablets.
Bantron has a buffered formula that works fast, helps curb your craving for nicotine.
Good.
One Bantron tablet after each meal.
Mm-hmm.
That's my plan. I'm through with smoking.
Hey, this calls for a celebration.
Bantron tablets have the most effective formula you can buy to make it easier to quit smoking. The more you want to stop smoking, the more Bantron will help you stop. Use only as directed.
Honey, you want two eggs or one?
Hey, you're full of life this morning.
I feel great. I really slept last night.
Well, that's wonderful.
It's surprising, too. I started out tossing and turning. Then I composed myself.
Composed yourself?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, yeah, that sleeping aid you took last night. Composed.
Right. I took Compose and felt nice and drowsy. Dozed right off and slept great.
On those occasional sleepless nights, compose yourself.
Take Compose. A good night's sleep pays off next morning. C-O-M-P-O-Z. Use only as directed.
The Guardian Angels want New Jersey's Attorney General to intervene following the shooting death of one of their members by a policeman last week. Curtis Sliwa heads the Citizens Protection Group, and he'll be with the victim's widow at a march to New Jersey's Capitol Sunday.
I and Mrs. Melvin and her two children will go upstairs, plead, beg, if necessary, for this man to intervene, not on behalf of the Guardian Angels, but on behalf of the quest of the citizenry of not just Newark and New York, but America, who have asked that justice be served.
Newark police say they mistook Melvin for a burglar when the shooting occurred. The Angels are now wearing red ribbons over their hearts in memory of Melvin, who was 26 years old. It's being reported but not confirmed that Gary Eads will be the new president of the Air Traffic Controllers Union. Eads was the only top-ranking executive of the union to be jailed for striking. I'm Carol Pazewski, NBC News.
Good morning, this is Pat McElroy with WJR News. Leaders of the United Auto Workers Union will make history this week when they meet to decide whether contract negotiations with Ford and GM should begin within the next month or two, or whether they should be postponed until summer when the current contract's near expiration. An automotive trade publication says the selling rate for new cars by the end of 1982 is expected to be one-third higher than the current depressed levels. The leader of a protest group in Montague opposed to poisonous waste shipments from the Flint area says she hopes for a good turnout in a demonstration scheduled for Monday when a second truckload of the toxic waste is expected. Marla Denstedt of Perry, the mother of a brain-damaged three-year-old girl, was awarded an out-of-court settlement that could amount to $13 million. The president of Northern Michigan University says the government should allocate money for ongoing studies of Project ELF if the system is built in the Upper Peninsula as planned. And police say a 10-year-old girl was fatally shot in the head by a man who riddled her Romulus home with gunfire after an argument with the girl's father. Police say 37-year-old Ronald Taylor, who allegedly argued with the dead girl's father, is being held without bond in Wayne County Jail for the shooting. In sports news, in NFL playoff action, it was San Diego 41, Miami 38, and Dallas swamped Tampa Bay 38-0. Buffalo meets Cincinnati tomorrow in the AFC playoff game. The winner will meet San Diego in the AFC title game. The Giants and the 49ers clash in tomorrow's NFC playoff game. The winner meets Dallas. In college basketball, it was Virginia 73, James Madison 65, Kentucky over Georgia 68-66, Wichita State down New Mexico State 63-50, DePaul over Penn State 86-60, Texas Tech 79, Arkansas 74, Missouri beat Notre Dame 92-70, it was Iowa 57, South Carolina no score. Usually the first one, Iowa would probably be the winner in that contest. They lack a score here. Minnesota 75, Long Beach State 67, Louisville over Duke 99-61. It was Tennessee 88, Alabama 67, Georgetown 75, Robert Morris 58. Tulsa beat Oklahoma 98-96. North Carolina State down Clemson 75-59, and Wake Forest over Georgia Tech 74-56. In NBA action, Atlanta 97, New Jersey 95, Washington beat Indiana 107-103. It was Boston 106, Cleveland 103. The New York Knicks had the best of the Detroit Pistons, 121-108. Milwaukee 128, Chicago 121, and San Antonio beat Denver 148-133. In National Hockey League action, the Red Wings beat the Colorado Rockies 3-1. It was Washington 5, Vancouver 2. The New York Islanders over Chicago 5-3. Edmonton Boston tied 4-4. Pittsburgh beat Hartford 9-4. Minnesota 6, Toronto 2. And the Rangers 6, Montreal 5. And Quebec beat Buffalo 6-3. Weather forecast from the WJR Weather Center. Winter storm warning in effect tonight. The Weather Center forecast from Ken Kurtzeal calls for cloudy and windy conditions, a combination of snow, freezing rain, and rain. And then the whole thing becoming generally rainy overnight as the temperatures slowly rise. For Sunday daytime, cloudy with periods of rain on a high near 40. The outlook for Monday, cloudy, rain changing over to snow, snow possibly heavy at times, and temperatures slowly falling through the day on Monday. Currently, the barometer is at 29.88, winds from the southeast at 14, the humidity is 67%, cloudy skies, and 35, the current temperature. MEP reports no accidents or adverse conditions at this time. Motorists should use caution as the freezing rains move into the area. And we've had some reports on I-75 in the Flint area and roads in general in the Flint area being extremely glazed and icy. Cars not being able to navigate overpasses and ramps at all, spinning out and moving in the wrong direction and so forth. So caution is advised on I-75 in the Flint area. Stay tuned to Radio 76, where news comes first every hour. And now enjoy the next hour of Night Flight 76. We'll be right back. Manhattan Melody. Manhattan, our destination on Night Flight 76 tonight. Carly Simon, next up. Another Hoagy Carmichael tune.
Surely break my